Hi guys, welcome to episode 10B of the Sputnik Challenge for Workers and Resources of the Republic. My name is Kaya Maya. And 10B, I am recording today, and today is January the 6th. And I'm also releasing today, probably. And I got the idea to make some sort of recap episode, and also, I was thinking of a way to interact more with you and play the game together. So I thought, well, maybe I can propose what directions we are going after this, and we can play the game together and make decisions together a little bit for the bigger decisions. And mostly, I want to make this episode because I want to thank you. I appreciate your support so much, and creating the episode is very much fun, but at least as fun it is to watch your to read your responses and to interact with you. So thank you so much for your support. So let's zoom out a bit here. What I want to do first is kind of recap on what we did in the last episodes, and then I want to little bit of a sneak peek of the future, and also I want to ask my question to you on where to go. I am currently in recording episode 19, and there I really want to think about how we are going to create the Sputnik monument. What strategy to use there, but I'll get back to that later, because when we started our Sputnik challenge, we started here, and we first of all had to create construction offices here just to create the road to nowhere, which went quite quick to create. I had some tests before that I divided the road in two, and having two how do you call this, two bulldozers creating the road, but that wasn't a lot quicker than creating it in one time. I had to do with you can only have so many dumpers, and now the dumpers only have to go back and forth here and here. If you have the road in half, you have dumpers having to go here, and so that caused that this road didn't get enough gravel. So then I decided just one road here. And so we had our construction offices set up here, and which are working quite well. I must say, I am still not really sure how to set up the cranes right. I am in the last episode, I had another approach which I recorded, so that will be that's the first peek in the future. I really enjoyed here how quick everything got set up and built. But even then, we were so micromanaging everything, or I, or we, because we were playing together, that who could have thought or would have thought that 2 days before March 18th, everything would be done. And I really loved that episode. And I also must say that watching that, I came across way different than it sounded in my head. You know, you have to say it sounded so much different in my head. So next time I will definitely be a bit maybe concise or something. I don't know the right word, but yeah, Gregor, you're right. I should have, or could have a time to reflect something. So after episode 19, expect that. And I do think we are may now that not a lot of people have suffered from our beginning without heating, because no escaped and then death. Yeah, maybe they were just really unhealthy people. And so, yeah. Well, what we're going to do in the future, because we also planned here, And this is going to be our first industry, our uranium, and we're going to have some fuel here and some bitumen here. So yeah, that's for the next episodes, I guess. And so what we're going to do in the future, mainly, I want to show you a little bit. Our monument, for now, we have set it here. And this is not the place. This is just to show you where, or sometimes show you the stats, if I can find it. Where are you? Oh, here. It's not a small monument. Just a little bit show you the stats about 400,000 workdays and stuff like that. But we want to work towards creating the monument. And so there are for me two approaches to creating it, wherever it goes. One is trucking everything in and creating construction areas, creating your steel and mechanical components, researching everything. And then having a construction area near where the monument is going to be, and having storages like that. And then at one point, with a lot of trucks, just start creating and building the monument and kind of fine-tuning how the trucks are going into the monument, because it also takes time. Wait a minute, let's make you a little bit smaller. If your entrance would be here, I don't know where the entrance is, here. To have the trucks go to the half of the monument, deliver everything and go back, and in such a way that you don't get enormous gems and things like this. So going the truck route would be one way for me. But the other option, I want to go back to where I was. Let me do that first, because I'm... Oh yeah, here. But the other option could be, if I look at Cheap's Let's Play, and also my own experience with this map where I created steel on this island using helicopters only. Helicopters are pretty powerful, and it would also make it would also be much fun for me to create helicopters. And for that, we need to create an airline production line, and we have to create helicopter construction offices, and we have to invest probably in dollars or in rubles, make a lot of rubles in order to buy the license and things like this. And for me, it would also be a lot of fun to see how all these helicopters go back and forth, creating the monument. And both are fun options for me. But if we go by road, I would suggest we pick a place where the monument is going to be on this island, and not on one of those islands. Because creating a bridge, after my creating steel on the island, the Theros who I was doing the roundtable with created a bridge from here to here, I believe. And that took him like 19 years or something. So I don't want to spend 19 years watching a bridge being built. That was a steel bridge or a railway bridge, but still. So I would suggest, if we go by truck, then we set a space for the monument here. But with plane, we can set it anywhere, to be honest. And... what else do I wanted to tell you? Yeah, I want to thank you, but I also want to thank my friends Kachip, Chris, Dennis and Toliki for having such a fun Discord together. And also take a look at their channels, because they have some excellent Let's Plays. And Oliki now started tutorial how to start in realistic mode and create this city there, which is loads of fun and lots of tips. And well, Dennis has always challenges which you know are not doable, but he still manages to do that, so that's also fun. And Chris is finishing his Fjordland map and getting the monumental area. Sorry, Chris, if I... you have another word for it, but the city, the... Okay, just... they're all friends of my channel. Take a look, check them out. Loads of fun. And so, also a last question. Is this something you're interested in? Like helping decide what our direction is going to be, and at a later stage also decide where you would like the monument to have? Or is it, well, Kaima, just play and you do you? And so I just thought I would like to try this. Also, one last remark. We are now going to air episode 10 to 20, and it's going to be one episode a day. And over the Christmas, I had some bad news. And I, at episode 15, 16, you can really see that I'm distracted here and there. I still decided to keep it up anyway and not re-record it, because I don't like to re-record episodes, to be honest, unless there's a technical difficulty. But that should pick up at episode... It's 15, 16, and in episode 17 you can really see it pick up again. So I just wanted to give you a heads up so that you know why I'm blurry there sometimes. So I want to thank you for watching if you've made it until so far. And I hope to see you tomorrow when we are going to air episode 11. Thank you. Bye-bye.